What's going on, guys? JSGC here, and we are here for another Manchester City video. We are here to review, analyse, talk about, whatever you call it. We're here to talk about the Manchester City Community Shield win over Chelsea. A fantastic 2-0 performance. There is no better way to build up or prepare for the Premier League season than going up against another Premier League side with a trophy on the line to go and win it. And then send out a statement to everyone else in the Premier League to say we were record breakers, we were the best last season, and guess what? We're still the best this season. And that's what this performance has shown. Man City were not as prepared as Chelsea. Chelsea's played more pre-season matches, they've had more minutes, yet Manchester City looked fresher, they looked hungrier, and looked like they wanted it more. And that's ultimately what's made the difference in this game, because if you look at the stats, which I'm just going to go through in a second, if you just look at the stats, they're very close. Talking about attacking football, we're talking about Pep Guardiola and Sarri's style of football, which is very similar, which is building it from the back, working it with possession, playing high lines. Very similar. Chelsea ended up having 47% possession. Manchester City ended up having 53% possession, which is very close, because Man City normally have, against most Premier League sides, around 60 to 70% possession. Chelsea, for the large majority of the game, up to the last 20 minutes, actually had more possession. They had 51, 52% possession. So Chelsea comfortable on the ball. They had ish chances, but Manchester City weren't really allowing Chelsea to get in. They had one chance which was shot straight at Bravo, which Bravo parried. They had a couple of chances in the first half, which particularly the young lad, though, he ended up having a very impressive game, having a couple of shots. Kyle Walker wasn't allowing him to go on his left foot, so he kept going on to his right foot. His name is Hudson Odoi, is that how you say his name? But yeah, he had a very impressive game for Chelsea. Chelsea, of course, if they had Eden Hazard in this game, would probably have stood a better chance of doing something in this game, because I thought that they lacked that little bit up front, and that, which is what Hazard offers to Chelsea. It would be a completely different story if he was playing in the game, but he wasn't. And ultimately, Manchester City, going with a very strong side, ended up winning the game. Man City pressing and closing into the space was absolutely fantastic. Fernandinho was here, there and everywhere. The unsung hero. Bernardo Silva did absolutely fantastic, particularly in the first half when Bernardo Silva was playing in the central role. Phil Foden was here, there and everywhere, trying his hardest, trying to intercept. His strength wasn't his asset. His passing, when it first started off the game, it was a bit wayward, but it started getting better as the game progressed, and I think he got assists in this game, and he was absolutely superb as the game went on. It was an absolute joy to watch, and if I'm honest, we were without David Silva, we were without Kevin De Bruyne. That's equally just as big a loss for Chelsea with Eden Hazard. We were missing a couple of our best central midfielders, two of the best central midfielders in the world, and we looked so comfortable. The problems of this, we need to sign a central midfielder. Well, it's making me think, I'm not too sure. Bernardo Silva might be seen in a central role, which gives nice backup for David Silva if ever he doesn't need to play. We've got Bernardo Silva as an option. Obviously, we've got Gundogan, we've got Fernandinho, we've got De Bruyne. We've also got Brahim Diaz that can go in central, and Phil Foden is now another option for Manchester City. So we're talking about a lot of numbers here. So obviously, we've got Fabian Delph that can also go in there. So there's a lot of numbers here. So it's not a disaster if Man City end up signing no one else in this transfer window. We proved it was so comfortable. Jorginho made his debut for Chelsea. He was very good on the ball at times, and he was still trying to work out when to pass the ball, when not to. Man City caught him in possession a couple of times. Man City on the counter-attack, fantastic. In the first half, we were sensational at it. Lirasane took a heavy touch. We ended up scoring a goal. Sergio Aguero coming about from Chelsea mistakes, and Chelsea, Man City just finding the gaps here, there and everywhere. But Manchester City, fantastically well. So we'll crack on with how the game went. So Manchester City obviously took the lead on 13 minutes. It was a good finish by Sergio Aguero. Sergio Aguero neatly tucked in. I think it was Phil Foden that got the assist. Good build-up play, and Sergio Aguero ended up finding the corner and putting it past Caballero in the net. And then in the second half, the second goal came about of a similar fashion. I think it was Bernardo Silva who fed it. It was good build-up play. John Stones with the interception building up to that was just fantastic, and then ended up going to Sergio Aguero, who just fires low and hard past Caballero into the net. And if I'm being honest, this could have been three, could have been four. Like I said, Lirasane took a heavy touch to Brahim Diaz that hit the side net in. Sergio Aguero, when he rounded Caballero, hit the side net in. Chelsea were just at sixes, at sevens at time, and Man City's build-up play, attacking in numbers, defending in numbers, and pressing in numbers, like I said, just completely dominated. Man City just looked so much fresher, so much better And I'm really excited now for the start of the season. I was dreading this Arsenal away match under new management, but we've just breezed past Chelsea. Arsenal have got a week now to prepare. They've got to have, they must have been watching that game and thinking, ah, Man City still look clinical and Man City still look dangerous. What do we do? And they've got to have a full preparation and plan in place now. So Arsenal, seriously hard work. For Manchester City, they're just going to do the same. They're just going to turn up in training, have a laugh, just pass it about, press it about, practice on the pressing, practice the passing, practice a bit of the goalkeeping and shooting, because that's all Manchester City ever seemed to do. And then just turn up and basically go through the gears and watch as teams just shred in front of them. If I'm honest, we're looking for a couple of bits to pick on. We can find bits to pick on in this game. I'd thought that Leroy Sané and Riyad Mahrez were looking for a little bit more sharpness. That is obviously going to come as games go on. They're attacking players. You can't expect attacking players just to find the feet straight away. It's going to take weeks for them to get that. And unfortunately, we have the international breaks sandwiched right in between them, probably finding their momentum, which hampers them. The international break is just a complete pain. It is, because you get one in October too, and then into November, it just starts derailing that momentum, which is where you're looking for players just to find the feet straight away. So hopefully soon they'll be able to find their feet. Benjamin Mendy, considering he's not had a lot of football over the last year, was absolutely fantastic in this game, getting forward, dictating play. Like I said, it looked sharp, it looked very good. Kyle Walker didn't look tired. John Stones taking his World Cup form into the Premier League season. There's just so much to look forward to. It was an absolutely superb performance, this. I was expecting a couple of youngsters to play. I think the young Bolton at right back, he's picked up an injury, so he didn't play in this game. Kyle Walker's ended up playing the game instead, which is very good for Manchester City, because he's ended up working with that, and we've ended up getting quite a bit of momentum. So we know that Kyle Walker can play next week. So we're going to go through the stats here. So just getting these stats up now, so we can have a look at the stats and see what they say. But it suggests a complete domination from Manchester City in areas, and then Chelsea keeping things close in others. So total shots, Man City ended up having 18 shots, 9 of which on target, 50% rate. That's excellent. That's very good. Chelsea with 5 shots, 2 on target. In terms of passes, similar amount of passes. Man City had just under 600, so 586 passes at a pass completion rate of 90%. Chelsea just a bit below at 525 passes at an 87% pass completion rate. Not a lot to pick from there. Wembley's pitch is very big, so Man City are never going to complete 800-900 passes, even 1,000 that we've seen before. The pitch is very big, so that's not going to happen. Obviously, going forward, Man City creating 5 clear-cut chances compared with Chelsea's 1. Man City connecting with 3 of their crosses from 10. Chelsea also had 10 connecting with just 1. Both got improvements to work on there in terms of defence. Chelsea ended up making 2 more tackles than what Manchester City did. Man City's tackle completion a lot better. Chelsea's at 50%, Man City's at 75%. That's a huge difference there. And Man City ended up making more clearances, 17 compared with Chelsea's 11. And also aerial duels, we ended up having the same amount, 17 each. Chelsea having 41% of their aerial duels won, so 7 out of 17. Man City won 10 out of the 17, which is just under 59%. Absolutely fantastic, that. Absolutely fantastic performance from the defence, build-up play, Laporte, John Stones. I am really excited about seeing that centre-back partnership. And I have to admit, John Stones is becoming one of my favourite players. If he can take the momentum from the World Cup, because he was phenomenal at the World Cup, he can take that into the Premier League season. The Man City have got themselves an absolute asset there. We've got Benjamin Mendy coming back. We've got so much to look forward to. We've got young prospects, Brahim Diaz worked so hard and worked so well in this game. I'm wondering if Man City will loan him out to Girona now or not. There's so much to think about for Pep now, and it's all good headaches. But at the end of the day, we're Community Shield champions. We are Premier League champions. We are the League Cup holders. Pep only needs to win the FA Cup and Champions League, and then he has won absolutely everything that there is to win at Manchester City. And you know what? We can do that this season. We really can. I'm really looking forward to the game. So we're going to have a preview up for that Arsenal game later on in the week. We're going to have a Premier League prediction table where I think everyone's going to finish coming up at some point this week too, for you all to look forward to, as well as the latest in Manchester City news. We've got a new series starting covering all things of Manchester City news and talking points. So if you're interested, make sure that you have subscribed with notifications on. We've also got plenty of transfer updates, transfer news to be talking about and getting through to, we've got deadline day coming up, and Man City will be involved with business ins, possibly, certainly outgoings as well. So stay tuned for that one. Make sure that you have subscribed, notifications on. Leave a big thumbs up if you did enjoy the video. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Make sure you congratulate all the players. Let me know who you think was your man of the match. I'm torn between Aguero and Bernardo Silva. I can't pick between them, so I'm going to give it to both of them. But John Stones, Phil Foden, Benjamin Mendy, etc., etc. Just the whole team was fantastic. Everyone deserves a shout-out and plaudits in this game. So absolutely fantastic performance. So we've got plenty more content coming up. Make sure that you are subscribed. Make sure you leave a big thumbs up if you did enjoy this video. Social media links there in the description below. If you want to go and check me out on them, I'll keep you up to date with all things happening with me and with Manchester City. And I'll see you all next time. I'm going to leave links up to my partner channel, Mixer Do Mix All the Drinks, and my gaming channel, JSGC Games. You'll go and like and subscribe over there if you wish. Go check out my other videos. Just did a football vlog yesterday from Press. If you're interested, you can go check that out. I'll leave a link to that at the end of this video. And I will see you all again tomorrow. Daily football content, daily Manchester City video. So I'll see you all then. It's been JSGC. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Peace. Ciao for now.